Hi, I'm Chris. Welcome to my channel. If this is the first time you're watching my video, please make sure you read on the description and the title below for the current software version that I'm using right now. My goal with this channel is to help you to become a better modular. So please take a moment and let me know in the comment how am I doing. Remember to leave a thumbs up so it can help the YouTube to share this video with a wider audience. And if you aren't subscribed, please do so and click on the bell for future content. Hi, welcome back to my channel. In this video, I'm going to talk about Glodon axis grid line with a bracket x. So what is actually is a x? X means that it's a height function. When you done the axis, you can able to height and unhide. So before we go into this axis, I want to tell you that more about why do you need this axis grid line at all? What is it? And where do you find this thing and how you're going to do this axis grid line in later in the video. So what is the axis grid line? So you see this green line in the software later, they consist of x axis, which is horizontal line, and the y axis is considered the vertical line, and the intersection point is 0, 0. There will be a cross over them. And where do you find this axis grid line? It's a top left and below for the floor selection. Show you example here in TS. You see the axis line is appear over here. If you sometimes it won't appear, we just have to click on this axis line with a gray highlighted this word. If you click on it, it will appear the axis. So the axis will appear on this view tab, revision, quantity, view, draw, identify, BIM model, project setting, but not on the start and also not in the icon here. You are unable to see the axis grid. See? So for myself, I prefer you go to a tab and you start do everything from here, include the axis and column and others as well. So because every tab here, it will, when you click on it, it will appear other ribbon. Because in here they have their other function as well. So since you are doing draw function, modeling function, I prefer you go to a draw tab over here and start to do all your modeling entities over here. Alright. So why do you even need this axis? So axis serve as a grid line for the model. Same as the drawing you imported. But the axis serve more than just than that. The software itself able to recognize it and will speed up your modeling. So what do you mean by speed up is that quickly generate the entities from the axis line. I will show you an example later. So right now I will show you why this how the software able to recognize. I will give you one example. This example is actually in the function in only appear in TRBC. This function calls rebar arrangement in BIM, which is on this one. So I will talk about this function later in the next later video. So right now you just have to focus on the axis, which is the A, B, 1 and 2 on this area, not too much on the rebar. So as you can see, I have done the 4 beam here. I select one of this beam. When I select one of this beam, the beam coordinate is A/1-2. Which after select, you jump into another window. In this window, you can see the beam is in the A axis 1/2. So if you change the alphabet or the number for the axis over here and the distance, it will eventually affect on the quantity and the coordinate itself. Okay, make sure you've done this thing correctly. So type of axis that can be created in TASC-III and TRBCIII. So there are few types over here: octagonal axis, arch axis, diagonal axis, or combination of both and combination of all type of axis. So here I will show you some example that I done. From here, octagonal, you can be that do something like this, and something like that, and something like this. And the arch, you also can do something like this. Diagonal, and combination of both and combination for all. So ARC means arc axis, ORT means octagonal axis, DIA means diagonal axis. So from here you can see these are the sample of combination of three type of axis, and this is arc and diagonal. In this section of the video, I'm going to teach you how do you identify axis and the method of create axis line. So let's jump into it. So right now, the first thing you need to do is that you make sure your identify tab is selected, which means that it's selected is at the highlighted in blue over here. When you select on this identify, the ribbon over here will appear identify, and there's an axis. This axis here is actually related to the axis that you selected over here. Let's say you move on the wrong tab, such as draw. You are unable to see the identify tab over here and also the other tab as well. So you have to go back to identify tab. Then the ribbon will be changed accordingly. And then the next thing is that make sure you have to select the entity here correctly. Let's say I select it on the column, it will appear column. When I select to axis, it will appear axis. Right, the first step is that you have to open up the drawing. All this drawing is ready. And then click on the axis, pick on the axis. Left click once. It will appear this entity selected mode. From here, they got three types of selection. One is free. You can either select manually one by one. You can see left click to select. When I select, it will become a blue color. Unpress it again, it will unselect. By layer, usually this is the most popular section that we use because it is the highest productivity and the fastest, because this software able to detect the layer drawn by the draftman. Let's say this architect draftman has drawn this layer, border has to be correctly. So when you select on the layer, you will select all the layer all together. And lastly, you will select by color. This color is very depending because if the layer is not perfect, you have to use the color to select. Let's say here if we got red color and purple color, then you will select everything included the wall layers as well. So in this case, this drawing is quite perfect in the layer, in sense of the axis layer. So we just have to click and then right click to confirm, follow the next step over here. As you can see the below here, it will tell you the step by step. Right click to confirm, and then all the axis is gone. Yeah, and do not worry that it's gone, it's actually in the pick layer over here. Once you click on the pick layer, so unclick all the original and then click on the layer and click on the axis, it will appear over here. Right, okay. And then we move on to the next step and click it again, click on the original layer. We're going to pick on the label, select this one, left click, and then same, it will appear the selection mode. This time we will select by layer. Right now the case is different. You can see when I select on the layer, it will appear almost everything is selected. You see this thing, this title over here is selected, and then all these things is selected as well. Right, so from here we can use a function called free select, unclick it, press escape to unclick everything, select again, pick label, select the free select, and then you just highlight this area. By means of highlight is that you press on the left click and drag from below, or maybe you can drag from above. So from here you need to search for the another layer over here, which means you don't have another one, so it's alright. So we just have to select this one, right click to confirm, and right now you can also use back the same function over here, click on the layer and the label, then you can see all this thing is selected. Let's say some of the part that you not satisfied that you should not be selected, you can use this function called restore cat entity. Click on this one, you can using the drag function that I taught you just now, left click, hold left click, and then release. You will see this thing is selected, and right click, it will go back to the original form, which means go back to the original layer. So in this case, I don't want to do this, but I just perform this as an example to let you see that you able to use this function to release it from pick to back to original layer. So I click on the back function to back from the original one that we used to do. Okay, so right now is that all the layer has been selected. Yes, click on the original layer. So one thing is about this pick axis that it won't appear over here. Yeah, you see, compared with the created axis, it will appear over here if created any new axis. But for this one, it will just appear inside the software itself because you treat the software tree as a layer. In this part of the video, we're going to talk about how to identify axis in PDF. So the function, I will be using the same function and the method as well. Make sure you click on the drawing PDF drawing. So in this PDF drawing, this is actually cat converted, which means that the layer still remain. Okay, just we have to make sure they're at the right scale. So after you measure at the right scale, so we have to click on the axis using the same method. Select the layer, same as before, left click, check, and then right click, select the label. Since this label has some unable to select, because when you select, it will select everything together. So click again to unselect. You can use free select to click on the label. Okay, then right click to confirm. And then auto identify. Here you go. So in this part of the video, I'm going to teach you how to create a new axis. So from here, as you can see, this is drawing is a picture format, which may be a PDF converted or maybe picture by itself. So you once you can't select any of the line over here, you have to create a axis. So from here, you can use either identify or drawing tab over here, it will be the same. It will not affect on you creating the new axis. Move over here, press on the blue cross over here to create a new axis. Then you use the type of axis that is similar to your drawing, which is octagonal. When you select of this axis, it will appear this define window. This define window can move around, but you're unable to zoom in or move any from the drawing behind. So for my personal preference, I would prefer to open up a PDF, something like this, and move it to my left screen, and you can insert accordingly. In this case, the only part of the using the axis is top and right. Top is referred to this one, and right is referred to this one. So right now I will insert the figure straight away from here by clicking on the distance. Double click, or you can click accordingly, something like this, or press add. Same goes to the right hand side. When you click on the figure, when it appears, you will see it will be something like this. So I have to click on everything or the figure. So after you key in everything, you need to check accordingly to this one. So I move my drawing over here, make sure everything is correct. 6, 7 and 2256, 4105, correct. So right now I'll teach you some function. Let's say you accidentally key in the axis number incorrectly, something like this. You can always use it auto sort. Click on this one, it will appear reset to the axis that you want. But remember that if you purposely want to change any axis over here, something like this one, if you click on this one, it will reset by default. It will change to 1 to 4 in this case by order. Right. The next thing we're gonna talk about is this level. So this level means that here is a first level, and here is a second level. In this case, there will be another level over here, 6706. If you want this 6706 to appear, which is over here, you click on this one, 4005, click on 2250 here, click it, the layer 3, then it will appear 6706, just like this one, right? Same, go to the right hand side over here, this one is 21 something, it's the sum of 825 plus 1 275 here. You click on number 2 on this one, it will jump another figure over here, and it will be just like this one. So right now you have to just make sure you key in this axis number, and do not make on any, do not click on this auto sort, because you purposely make it this one to be empty, because you don't want this to appear same as this drawing, right? FHD. Just key in F, H, and D. And so on. So after you key in everything in order and to what you're liking, so the next step will be putting this axis line onto this drawing. So we have this function called set intersection point. By setting this intersection point, you see the yellow cross over here, it will allow you easy to point this axis onto the drawing. For example, I'll put over here because I want to point over here. Press OK, and then you see the axis will simply, they will just simply randomly just put your axis, or you can just use two functions. Either you move the axis line over here, select the axis line and press move to here, or you press on the point to create a new axis line. Just point to this point over here. Make sure you click on this random point, because if you don't click on this random point, it's quite hard to you to point any axis. As you can see, I left click to point, it will not appear. So for your information is that this is a scan copy, what they call it, picture. Eventually, it won't be 100% up to skill. As you can see here is that even though how do you measure or how do we scale this drawing, it will definitely like some difference between the actual axis line. So this is a problem with the pictures and scan. So that's all for this video. Thank you for watching.